Immediately, and they are set to go. The first of nine on Jolly Beggar Stakes Day. Gates are back now. They're off and they're racing. Fast Flicker dwelt at the start. The first to go, Queen Ship out deeper. Ruler Rocket now spearing through. Sir Mambo also charging up towards the lead, and it'll be Sir Mambo onto the course proper with a slender lead over Queen Ship. So Turner's going to have Ruler Rocket third down on the inside of Platinum Class. A length and a half there. Further back is Blow Me Out. Then Paddy's Flying Snag back to second last in front of Fast Flicker. To the turn they head at the fourth. 450. Sir Mambo leads the way by three quarters on Queen Ship. He was keen to extricate off heels with Ruler Rocket and came out three deep, and so Platinum Class got shoved out four and five wider. Rails run back towards the inside, Blow Me Out, and Paddy's Flying winding up on the extreme outside. At the 200, Ruler Rocket races to the lead, a length and a half with Paddy's Flying in pursuit. It's finishing powerfully, Paddy's Flying. Paddy's Flying draws equal with Ruler Rocket. It gets its head in front, Paddy's Flying. Ruler Rocket kicks, but Paddy's Flying narrowly. Paddy's Flying a whisker from Ruler Rocket in a great go to the line here in the first for the day. Tight for third, too Fast Flicker, Platinum Class. They were followed home by Blow Me Out, then Sir Mambo weakening, as did Queen Ship, who dropped out to finish back there at the rear. Paddy's Flying, Joseph as a party, wins the opening event and upsets the favourite Ruler Rocket. Photo for third. 2-3, tight tussle, third placing. Paddy's Flying, though, from second last. Down the outside, the interim numbers are 2-3, 6 and 7. 2-3, 6-7, Paddy's Flying, Ruler Rocket, Platinum Class, and Fast Flicker on return, a good run as well. So Paddy's Flying makes it 2-for-2 this campaign. It's now 4 from 7, and a very good effort by the patronised gelding. Was back there following Platinum Class. Came to the middle of the track. Turner was keen to get off heels and get going on Ruler Rocket, but no match for Paddy's Flying, who backs up off the Pinjarra 1,000-metre win back on Aug 17 with this victory. By Patronise, out of Rio Flyer for the Darling View Thoroughbred team, Bridge Patrol, Lodge, and also Grant Burns at Premium Bloodstock, and building up quite a winning record, Paddy's Flying. Ruler Rocket by Universal Ruler out of Extreme Dreams. Troy Turner for Bruce Watkins and Platinum Class. Neville Parnham, Lakdar Romilly combining a War Chant mare out of City Magic. And it's a long head, 1 3/4 official margins. They ran 58.51, 33.60. Strong tailwind behind them too, with that westerly prevailing at the moment. And a bit of a fluky wind out here at Belmont Park today for the meeting. So the first fave goes down, but it was the second elect here, Paddy's Flying, who was well respected too in the betting market, that has just got the job done. Race number two, the free entry to Belmont Park Plate. Over 1,200 comes the next at 12.44. Number nine comes out. That is Siberian Siren. So nine, Siberian Siren, the one scratching. As we head down now to the yard after the first for the day, and a victory here for Joey as a party and trainer Dave Harrison with Paddy's Flying.
Thank you, Darren. Obviously, Harrow over at Caulfield with Buster Bash, only 40 minutes away. So stable foreman Tony Triscari joins me now. Tony, speaking off air to you just then, the stable's always had an opinion of this horse, but he just needed a little bit of time to show his best.
Exactly, Lockie. Yeah, he's his first preparation. I think he won his first start, but he was very immature, still doing a lot of things wrong. Not eating that well, but now he's really settled into the routine and going exceptionally well.
He won a Class 5 down the straight at Pinjarra last start. He comes to town, wins a West Speed 1000. What's the ceiling to him?
Oh, look, I don't think Dave will give him any more. He's done a really good job this prep. He might go through a 66-plus now and have a crack at that and then probably look for the paddock, I'd reckon.
Over the last 200, your own mare was a little bit unlucky. What were you watching? What was that like for you?
Look, it was a hard one, but I actually was watching Paddy's Flying coming down the outside. I thought he was going to get up, and my one had a little bit of bad luck, but she ran a good race.
And a word on Buster Bash, as I said, in the Heatherly in about 40 minutes' time. How's Harrow assessing his chances today with Jamie Carr aboard?
Yeah, look, he's probably going to need the run again, Lockie. He's a horse that takes three or four runs to get to his top. He didn't settle as good as he could have. He didn't travel exceptionally well, but he's on track now, and this run, I think, will just be a pipe opener for him, and then he should be very competitive next start.
Well done here, and good luck for the rest of the day.
Good on you. Thanks very much.
There's Tony Triscari representing David Harrison over in Melbourne, obviously with Buster Bash. The stable rider for Buster Bash is Joey Azzopardi, and he's just about to weigh in and have a chat to Scotty Embry.
Paddy's Flying going really well this preparation. He won first up. I think Austin Gallardi rode him, but Joe was aboard last start. Joey, this horse here, he's going really well at the moment. Harrow's got him in a rich vein of form.
Yeah, the whole stable's going good, especially this horse. It was a good win last start at Pinjarra and thought he was a top chance today.
Today was always going to be a case of the awkward barrier and where you got to, but it looked like he was pretty comfortable back where you put him.
Yeah, the small field definitely suited. Like you said, the speed was good. We're back in the field, but we didn't have too many to get past and he was strong to the line.
Always confident up the home straight?
Yeah, I was. I know he's got a good turn of foot. I sort of saved him up for one run at him. I thought we were going to put the favourite away a bit easier and he sort of started pegging me back on the line, but yeah, I was confident.
Later in the day, Position of Power, also Red Dwarf and others. Looks like you got a nice even book.
Yeah, I got a few chances left. Position of Power, if he gets the right one in front, he'll run a good race and there's a couple other chances there.
Congratulations, well done.
Cheers, mate. Ta.
There's Joe Azzopardi combining with David Harrison and continuing their good form to take out the Tab Touch West Speed Platinum Handicap.
Down by the river, I was drawn by your grace into depths of oblivion and to the lover's place. I was stuck in a puddle full of tears and unwise. Stuck doing snow, know that we've paid unlike, and you know, hey, when we walked down the long, I feel like we can throw away the forces of a past. And I know, too, it's been the hardest days for you. Let's throw them out the window, that's what those lovers do.